glorious Avalokiteshvara is immediately synonymous with the word Bodhisattva, the quintessential superhero savior. In chapter 25 of the wondrous Lotus Sutra, Shakyamuni Buddha makes it clear that Avalokiteshvara rescues all beings who call the name of the Bodhisattva.
This chapter is sometimes referred to as the Universal Gate Sutra. In this treasured sutra, the world-honored Buddha also explained the countless forms of manifestation of the great Bodhisattva. Not only male and female, but any form that is beneficial to the Sangha. Especially on Avalokiteshvara Guanyin's special 3 days, celebrated on the 19th days of the 2nd, 6th, and 9th lunar months of the year, we recite the Universal Gate Sutra and chant the great Dharanis and mantras of Avalokiteshvara. Reciting out loud with faith purifies negative karma and is meritorious, with merit multiplied on Avalokiteshvara's 3 days or any Buddha day. Remembering with faith and understanding that Avalokiteshvara has countless forms and names, as explained in the sutra, you can call out any of his or her names. This sutra not only teaches the virtues of the great Bodhisattva of compassion as a savior for all beings who call out his name with faith, as well as his countless forms, but it also teaches the Bodhisattva aspiration. At the end of the sutra, when Akshayamati makes an offering to Avalokiteshvara, he at first refuses the offering. Shakyamuni Buddha asks Avalokiteshvara to accept the offering for the benefit of all beings. With this Bodhisattva aspiration, Avalokiteshvara accepted the offering. This emphasizes the point of dedicating the merit of all practices and offerings to the benefit of all sentient beings. Normally for recitation and for praises, we use the names of Avalokiteshvara, but we can also chant the name translated, such as Guanyin, Kannon, or Chenrezig, or in any language. Here, we recite Avalokiteshvara. If you prefer Guanyin or other names, you can substitute them. Likewise, some people say he, and some people recite she. Both are fine, as the great Bodhisattva is not limited to one form or gender. Recite along with us now the 25th chapter of the Lotus Sutra, known as the Universal Gate Sutra. Here begins the sutra.
At that time, Akshayamati rose from his seat, uncovered his right shoulder, placed his palms together, and facing the Buddha said, "World-honored one, for what reason is the Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara called Avalokiteshvara?" The Buddha told Akshayamati, "Good son, if any of the limitless myriads of innumerable living beings who are undergoing all kinds of suffering hear of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva and recite his name single-mindedly, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva will immediately hear their voices and rescue them. If a person who upholds the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva is in danger from a great fire, the fire will not burn him, all because of this Bodhisattva's awesome spiritual power. If a person being tossed about in the great flood calls out the Bodhisattva's name, he will find a shallow place. If a person ventures on the great sea, an evil wind may toss their boats. But if among them there is even one person who calls out the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, they will all be saved from storms and dangers. For this reason, he is called Avalokiteshvara. Further, if a person who is attacked calls out the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, not even a hair will be harmed. If demons and monsters torment a person, if they hear him call out the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, all those evil ghosts will not even be able to stare at that person with their evil eyes, how much the less harm him. If a person, whether guilty or not, who has been imprisoned calls out the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, he will be freed. If bandits infest a dangerous road on which a group of merchants travel, but among the merchants there is even a single person who says, "Good men, do not be afraid," you should all single-mindedly recite the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. This Bodhisattva bestows fearlessness upon living beings. If you recite his name, you shall surely be saved from these robbers. And if upon hearing that, the merchants all cry out together, "Namo Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva," then they will immediately be saved because they recited his name. Akshayamati, the awesome spiritual power of the Bodhisattva Mahasattva Avalokiteshvara, is as lofty and sublime as that. If living beings who have inappropriate desires constantly and reverently recite the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, they will be separated from desire. If those who have much hatred constantly and reverently recite the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, they will be separated from hatred. If those who are deluded or foolish constantly and reverently recite the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, they will be separated from delusion and foolishness. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva has great awesome spiritual powers such as these and confers great benefits. Therefore, living beings should always be mindful of him. If parents seek children, if they prostrate and make offerings to Avalokiteshvara, they will give birth to blessed, virtuous, and wise children who have planted roots of virtue in previous lives and who are regarded and respected by all. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva has powers such as these. If there are living beings who reverently bow to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, they will be blessed and their efforts will not be in vain. Therefore, living beings should all receive and uphold the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. Akshayamati, if a person were to receive and uphold the names of innumerable bodhisattvas, and in addition were, throughout their lives, to make offerings to them of food, drink, clothing, bedding, and medicine, what do you think? Would that good person's merit and virtue be great or not? Akshayamati replied, "Very great, world-honored one. The Buddha said if another person were to receive and uphold the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, and bow and make offerings but once, that person's blessings would be equal to and not different from the other person's. The merit could not be exhausted in hundreds of thousands of myriads of eons." Akshayamati, one who receives and upholds the name of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva obtains the benefit of blessings and virtues as limitless and boundless as those. Akshayamati said to the Buddha, "World-honored one, how does Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva manifest in this world? How does he speak the Dharma for living beings? How does he carry out this work with skillful means?" The Buddha told Akshayamati, "Good son, if living beings in any world must be saved by means of someone in the body of a Buddha, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva will manifest in the body of a Buddha and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a Pratyeka Buddha, he will manifest in the body of a Pratyeka Buddha and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a Shravaka or disciple, he will manifest in the body of a Shravaka or disciple and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a god, he will manifest in the body of a god and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a great heavenly general, he will manifest in the body of a great heavenly general and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a king, he will manifest in the body of a king and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of an elder, he will manifest in the body of an elder and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a layman, he will manifest in the body of a layman and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a minister of state, he will manifest in the body of a minister of state and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a monk or nun, he will manifest in the body of a monk or nun and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a heavenly dragon, Yaksha, Gandharva, Asura, Garuda, Kinnara, Mahuraga, human or non-human and so forth, he will manifest in such a body and speak Dharma for them. If they must be saved by someone in the body of a Vajra-wielding spirit, he will manifest in the body of a Vajra-wielding spirit and speak Dharma for them. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva has accomplished merit and virtue such as this, and in all manner of forms, manifesting throughout the countless world systems, saving and liberating living beings. Therefore, you should all single-mindedly make offerings to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva Mahasattva can, in the midst of fear, crisis, and hardship, bestow fearlessness. Akshayamati said to the Buddha, "World-honored one, I shall now make an offering to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva." He then removed his necklace of pearls, its value in the hundreds of thousands of ounces of gold, and offered it to the Bodhisattva, saying, "Benevolent one, accept this Dharma offering, this necklace of precious pearls." Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva refused to accept it. Akshayamati again said to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, "Compassionate one, out of pity for us, accept this necklace." The Buddha then said to Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, "You should take pity on Akshayamati and the fourfold assembly, as well as the gods, dragons, yakshas, gandharvas, asuras, garudas, kinnaras, mahuragas, humans, non-humans, and so forth, and accept this necklace." Then, out of pity for the fourfold assembly, the gods, dragons, humans, non-humans, and so forth, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva accepted the necklace. He divided it into two parts. One part he offered to Shakyamuni Buddha, and the other to the stupa of many jewels Buddha. Such is the self-mastery and spiritual power of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, who roams throughout the suffering worlds. At that time, Ksitigarbha Bodhisattva, guardian of the earth, rose from his seat and said to the Buddha, "World-honored one, if there are those who hear this chapter of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, who learn about the self-mastery of his deeds and the power of his spiritual penetrations as shown in this universal door, you should know that the merit and virtue of such people will not be small."
Here ends the Universal Gate chapter of the Lotus Sutra. may all beings benefit.